Banker and I'm reporting from Mr. Media today. I'm speaking with John Hercules. And he's having a marathon day here on July 14th. John, how are you doing this evening?
I'm well. Perfect.
Could you tell me a little bit about what your work consists of and what you're doing?
I'm an independent UFO researcher. It means that I'm not committed to a group or institution or whatever. And I work together with a foundation, what I founded myself together with David Summers, is Contact Network International. We have also a magazine, Exposure Magazine. And the idea is for my research is not only to investigate UFOs as such, but also the like a private eye type of work, not only scientific, but try to look behind the scene, why some things are covered up and why we are not told the whole truth about UFOs and the alien presence or the secret technologies and hidden technologies and suppressed inventions.
So this is what will be covered on
the 14th is a conspiracy marathon day. It's a label, of course, conspiracy, because a lot of people think you have to be a freak to say conspiracy. And I understand people thinking like that. But the idea is to be, for the media, for the people who are watching, is that they want to have a label on me, and I'm a conspiracy freak. Okay, so be it. But my information is well documented. I have contacts all over the world. For 6 years, I'm studying very hard with people who are in the intelligence community, from the police, military, and pilots, who have reported UFOs and have also reported suppression of information. Mm. This hidden technology and suppressed information is my hobby as such.
Have you had contact with Agent Stan Dio?
Not personally, but I have some friends who are working with him, and he made a documentary called An Hour with Stan Dio, and he's also had a book, Cosmic Conspiracy. He is an FBI agent, fled to Australia because he knew too much, and he is investigating anti-gravity and also new propulsion systems. And as you know, if you can lift up like that, you have a UFO. So it is all about free energy technology, and I have to say something about free energy. You know, something like solar energy, yeah? You have like a wave, it's light, it will be exchanged in energy. Mm-hmm. We accept it as a reality, that this is a fact. But can you remember that if you have the whole spectrum of waves, light is only a tiny, tiny speck on the whole possibilities of waves. So there's also infrared, there's also microwaves you can exchange in free energy. But this is military secret, secret for us. So there are more ways to get energy, free energy, and I've heard that the UFOs are using free energy. So if you are digging into the subject, you realize you don't have to put gasoline in the cars anymore, if you know what it's all about. So that is the main reason I think it's suppressed, the UFO subject. Not only about aliens, but also about inventions. So I'm trying to be down to earth as possible. Sometimes I'm researching in channeling business. So a lot of people know what it means. Channeling means that you have the psychic ability to have contact with higher dimensions. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean that everybody's telling the truth, but you have to realize that where that come all the ideas from. Like Einstein, he said he dreamt 14 hours a day, and most of his ideas came from his dreams. Mm-hmm. So you have to realize maybe there is a way to communicate with higher dimensions, so I don't reject it. But I'm also very skeptical about it. So I'm very, like this book, The Only Planet of Choice. You can see this book. This I can recommend it. This is very down-to-earth channeling. It's strange to say that because most channeling is not down-to-earth. It's mostly hallelujah and we will save by whatever. But this is not about saving by aliens, but you can help yourself. And this is not, and give some remarkable answers to difficult questions we have now on this planet. But first we go to Stan Dio.
Okay. Let's take a look at that clip, okay?
Yes. Here you have. He's a researcher as well.
A lot of folks have asked how I got started in the UFO research business. It's kind of hard to pick a starting point, like everyone else, since the mid-50s, when UFOs became a thing of the press. I was very interested. I spent some time at the Air Force Academy in Colorado as a cadet. and part of my physics science manual there did give us a little bit of official Air Force jargon about how to debunk UFO sightings and this sort of thing. So as early as about 1964 at the Academy, I was aware that there were official moves at hand to debunk UFOs, whether they were real or not. So after I got out of the Academy, I proceeded to go into normal business in the computing game in Dallas, Texas. As part of my civilian work, I was approached by the FBI to do some work.
So you heard, he's approached by the FBI. And then he said he has some research done from that because he is into anti-gravity, he's into free energy. That's interesting. When you're discovering something important, then you are being approached by intelligence community. So every inventor on this planet who has something discovered something revolutionary and it's important to know about, they take it, the information. They want to have it and they suppress it again or ridiculize it. So the idea from all of this is why are we not being told about it? And that's why I'm giving Conspiracy Mountain Day, to show you what's going to happen behind the scene.
So can you tell me a little bit about UFO contactees and Chandlers? Like, is this a place that people who've had experience with the UFOs would want to show up?
I've met a lot of people who claim to have contact with UFOs, aliens or extraterrestrials. What I don't like about the media is that they are very one-sided attention to the grays. The grays, the grays with large heads, with big eyes, slanted eyes, huge black eyes.
You see that very popular in fashion nowadays.
Yes, on t-shirts I see that, yes, and necklaces. I have myself also a necklace to provoke a discussion or whatever. And what I want to say about those aliens, those creatures, they're called the grays, because they are grayish, of course, and that necessarily means that they are alien. It is a possibility they are a product of genetic engineering. And this is horrific to know about. If this is true, when those gray type of aliens are a product of genetic engineering and they have no emotions, they have almost no emotion, they have an emotion to survive. But what I've heard is when you make a clone of yourself, and this guy makes a clone of itself and itself, you make a copy of a copy of a copy, then you die out. Your DNA is going to collapse. It doesn't function anymore. Yeah. So I've heard that they have a desire to survive. And put them in an anti-gravity machine we can build ourselves, so you have presenting the so-called gods. But what I've met, I talked to you about, I've met some people, a lot of people, who claim to have contact with aliens.
Yeah.
Most of them don't talk about gray as large heads. They have so many different type of aliens. You have aliens who have pure energy, like golden light beings, and they have also like a lot of interaction and knowledge.
Here, thank you, in Holland. You're very welcome here. Please tell me, how do you start and evolve this? I think it's a very complex subject. I think you can try to explain how it began.
Yes, it was 1985, September the 5th, 1985.
Yes.
I had an accident, a bicycle accident, where I was cycling on my bicycle up a hill as fast as I could to push myself through the pain barrier in my muscles. And at the top of the hill, the chain came off the bicycle. And it was dusk, so it was getting dark. I was looking up for the stars. And I flew over the handlebars, smashed the side of my head against the road, where everything turned into a dreamlike reality. And intense light started to surround me, and I went out of my body. I felt myself leaving my physical body and surrounded by a group of golden light beings.
And how close were they? Is it like this or like this?
No, they were
like this.
Something like this.
This close, okay.
But at the same time, there was energy or light. They were radiating first from golden light, and that energy was connected to me and to the surroundings. They were all connected to each other.
Mm-hmm. Interaction and knowledge. Some people call themselves channelers. It means they can write very fast information down, not from itself, but they are like a channel, give some information out. It doesn't mean that everything what you read is true, but it's just interesting to note that sometimes they ride so fast that you can ask questions, and before your question is asked, they already give the answer on paper. It's so strange to see. And of course, you have people who are baloney and telling rubbish, of course. I think about 80% of the so-called contactees or channelers are not that so good as they tell.
It seems that it would often also, a lot of the more believable reports come from army intelligence or
yes.
military-involved personnel.
Because the people are also have a consciousness, they think about themselves, what is my role in this reality, and do I have always to obey authority? If you have seen an alien, or if you have seen a UFO, as in someone from the military personnel, or police officer, or pilot, and you have experienced it, you can do two things. You shut your mouth, or you do something about it. Mm-hmm. And more people speak out. There have also been court cases from ex-military, ex-pilots, ex-policemen who have joined together with the forces, and they call themselves citizens against UFO secrecy. And they have won court cases against the CIA, the FBI, the NSA, National Security Agency. And piles of documents talks about radar confirmed UFOs. UFOs seen by, you see them like power plants, you have seen reported. Dogfight from air jets, you know, they have been sent to the UFO object. And then it's interesting to note that when there's a fighter airplane, yeah, coming towards the UFO, UFO are standing still in the air, and then like this, goes like this. You see what I mean? Mm-hmm. The same speed, and goes away. So there's always a distance. And then it's shoof away, you know, very fast. Yeah. First is like a cat and mouse play. And it has to be also on the Capitol, you know, in 1952 there was also a UFO seen above the Capitol in Washington, D.C.
My hometown.
Your hometown. And that was front page news, that a lot of strange objects seen over the Capitol. And a lot of people saying about, why don't they land on the White House lawn? Eh? This is always a silly question.
There's a movie coming out about that right now.
Oh, yeah, great.
Judgment Day.
There have been all of the planet dogfights, like UFOs being chased by aerojet fighter planes. And there's always the same result, they don't catch them, and so forth, and so forth. It doesn't mean that every UFO is an alien spacecraft. It can also be a test of secret military defense and so forth and so forth. But there are a lot of reports, maybe they are alien. And if they are alien, they are teasing us, like you can do nothing with your technology. We are far advanced. So yeah. Think about what you do with your play toys or your toys. And of course, we have some terrible things on with the airplanes. But most important is, like this book, the UFO cover-up. It's about what the government won't say, but they have it in their archives. And they talk about documents. Here, I can show you documents. Here, sample of UFO document files. You can see it. It's all documents from the FBI, CIA. Sometimes they have make it black, because you're not allowed to read it. So you have the court cases that can allow you a little bit to see something, and sometimes you see a lot. And it's all about policemen, pilots, and military personnel seeing UFOs. Mm. And also this book, Above Top Secret, The Worldwide UFO Cover-Up, is also fully documented with documents. Proof that UFOs exist. The discussion is not, are they really there? No, that's not the discussion. The discussion is, why are they there? What do they want? And what will be the impact? I think, if you think about it, when UFOs are aliens, of part of the real UFOs are alien presence. What for impact has it on our reality? It has a political impact, social impact, military impact, religious impact. So when you count them all up, can you think about something else that had so many groups against it? I can't imagine another subject have so much resistance to this subject. You have political consequences, military, social, fabric goes apart, and religious, of course.
Further than just some UFOs and things like that. It goes into secret societies and different conspiracies going on amongst human beings.
Yes.
Could you talk a little bit about the secret societies?
Secret societies play a major role in controlling the intelligence community. So if you want to try to think about it, who controls the intelligence community? Everybody thinks about the government should do that. But I know for a fact that secret societies play a major role to control information, to control the idea how some information should be presented towards the media. Like the one-sided approach of the Greys, it's very one-sided because there's a lot of other different type of aliens who deserve every attention but doesn't get it. So why this one-sided approach? And now we go back to secret societies. They want to have a world government. Like the Freemasons talk about new world order.
Secrets. Secrets which derive from the old days when there were recognition signals between craftsmen protecting their trade secrets, and we still use them now as a link with the past. But we're absolutely not a secret society.
Nevertheless, among the public, the fear persists that there may be more to the secrets than harmless ritual. And when cameras were invited to film in Grand Lodge for the first time, not everything would be open for scrutiny. Journalist Paul Foote has long campaigned against what he sees as Freemasonry's sinister power.
Which the secrecy of the association and the bonds that they tie each other up with, which is the sinister aspect of it. Most of the other organizations which bring together important people in the community, I mean the Rotary Club or the Round Table or organizations of like that, they can be discovered, if you like, by someone like me or you. We can go and find out who's the chairman of the Round Table or who's the chairman of the Rotary Club, and they throw their meetings open to the public and the press mingle with them and so on. Freemasonry, they mingle in secret.
Are you therefore willing to take a solemn obligation founded on the principles I have stated to keep inviolate the secrets and mysteries of the order?
I am.
Then you will kneel on your left knee. Your right foot formed in a square. Give me your right hand, which I place on the volume of the sacred law, while your left will support these compasses, one point presented to your naked left breast.
The impressionable apprentice Freemason undergoes a bizarre and powerful bonding. Nevertheless, many senior Masons dismiss concern about secret Masonic influence as an orchestrated campaign against the Brotherhood.
Naked left breast, to imply that had you rashly attempted to rush forward, you would have been accessory to your own death by stabbing. While the brother who...
The blood-curdling rituals of Freemasonry today were invented in the early 18th century. At that time of religious and political persecution, a fearsome oath of secrecy may have seemed essential, but can the same be true today?
Equally fatal. But the danger, which traditionally would have awaited you until your latest hour, was the physical penalty, a one-time associated with the obligation of a Mason, that of having your throat cut across had you improperly disclosed the secrets of Masonry.
Like the Freemasons talk about New World Order on the dollar bill. You see on the back side of the dollar bill, you see an all-seeing eye, and you see Novus Ordo Seclorum. It is Latin for New World Order. And there are Freemason symbols. If you study the symbols of Freemasonry and you study the dollar bill note, and it's okay, interesting to note that this dollar bill note is had a lot of symbols from black magic, like the spider webs around it. Yeah. If you see one dollar bill, you see spider webs. Why? Why the all-seeing eye? Why you see 13, 13, 13? 13 arrows, 13 steps, 13 letters in Anuit Septus. It's also Latin. It's Anuit Septus, the birth of New World Order. So it means why so much 13 and why New World Order?
Yeah.
Now, I've heard that the Freemasons have invested their plans to have a world government like 1998. So they are now preparing first by control of the Big Brother's chip card. They will be obligated. You see, also, I talk about Big Brother.
Yeah.
It's also a part of my conspiracy marathon day.
Big Brother?
Big Brother is watching you. It means that everything what you buy, everything where you rent, what you read, what you take for medicine, everything will be in computers because you start using the PIN code, PIN pushes, you know, the PIN. Mm-hmm. What here you have in Holland.
Yeah.
Then you have the chip card. It's the same card with a chip in it. And then you have your social number on it. So it's slowly, slowly we accept the reality that we have to control the people by the chip card, obligated it. Cash will go away slowly. And when cash goes away, then you have like a privilege system. You get privileges by obeying and by doing everything what government wants you to do. But if you go another direction, they know about it because they know what for books you read. They have barcodes on it. This barcode system is international. And whatever you buy, they know about it. So if you want to have a profile of someone, you can buy it. Wow. So if you have a lot of money, you go to a private investigator. You give him a lot of money and say, this is the guy I want to know more about.
And just type it in.
Yes, and this he goes to a hacker, computer hacker. You have good hackers and bad hackers. You have also a hacker who wants to have money. And then they have a profile on you and they can misuse power. If you, for instance, have a political magazine or you have videotapes you hire, do you want to know what that everybody knows what you hire? You don't want to know that everybody knows that. So it is important to note that why has this to do with the world government and UFOs and suppressed technology? At the moment that you are investigating UFOs, you realize we talk about suppressed inventions and free energy and anti-gravity. Then you read books about it. They know about it. Then you meet people doing the same thing. Then you have a type of group. But you still are independent, but you have groups who are critical to society. And those critical groups who are trying to be practical, who are trying to trace down those inventors, come to a point that they want to be independent. And you cannot be independent if they obligated your chip card. They can follow you. So if you want to say no to the chip card, you have to have all the suppressed inventions. You have to have knowledge about UFOs. Mm. Not necessarily to believe in a supreme being, but believe in yourself to be free, really free. But we are not free if we support the system. And this is interesting. All dissidents, like if you are a professor, or you are an important guy in the society and you read this type of books, or you go to lectures, or you go from A to B, they can follow you with their card. So if you are a political important guy who talks with me, it's in the computer. So it's...
So any diseases you'd have in your whole life would all be documented, anything?
As well. Also, if you take medicine, medicine has also barcode.
So everything would be anyone's business.
If you take ACT, everybody knows what it means. It means that you have AIDS. And then you try to have a job. Just try to get a job. It's difficult. Also, when you read a book about UFOs or other strange subjects, strange like this, of course, what is strange, is also to realize for what type of person will go on the top if you are screened. So when you want to have a job and it's a high place, they say, oh, who are you? And they can see who you are and what you read and what you... And that is terrible, but what type of person will be on the top? Obedience type of person, gray type person. No, and I think it's terrible.
It is terrible.
But we can do something about it. It's not about doomsday prophecy. We have some solution. And one.
Well, what can we do?
What we can do is first to speak out about our knowledge of suppressed inventions, because we need the inventions to be free. We now use gasoline because we are programmed to do that. If everybody knew there's an alternative invention, we don't have to necessarily use those engines. But because we are too, maybe I'm hard when I'm saying this, maybe we are too lazy. We don't want to investigate another part of reality. And if there is an inventor who discovered some very revolutionary, we need to know. Also for Greenpeace. Greenpeace should put money into this type of research. Put money to track down those guys who have been troubled with intelligence community or with multinationals. So this is for Greenpeace. Please investigate the possibility that there are researchers who have tracked down some interesting inventions. Mm. It's the more of what you want to know.
Yeah, I wanted to know a little bit about the secrets of the Third Reich, it says here.
Yes.
Well, this goes into a whole different era altogether, I guess.
This is, for a lot of people, hard to understand. But at the end of the Second World War, there were a lot of inventors, like Victor Schauberger, like Werner von Braun. There are a lot of top researchers in Germany, Nazi Germany, who have been taken to Russia, to Canada, to Brazil, to Paraguay, to America. And they all want to have those researchers and inventors and scientists. You know why?
Why?
Because they discovered more than they dreamt of. You know about V1 and the V2?
Only the TV show from when I was
born. No, I mean V1 and V2 is used against London. The Nazis used the V1 and the V2. There are rockets. Uh-huh. First rockets they used on with bombs to damage London and England. It's interesting to note that the Apollo flight, the Saturn, is made. Is the whole technology is from a Nazi scientist.
Wow.
And he's taking to America because they think when we don't do it, the Russians have them.
Yeah.
So it's important to have this knowledge. And the whole technology that goes from the man to the moon is from Werner von Braun and Victor Schauberger. So, but they invented much, much more. They invented also anti-gravity. And that is what we have. We have proof that there are much, much, we have also V3, V4, V5, V6 and 7. And there are projects, secret projects of the Nazis in the end of Second World War, and they have lifted a craft, and it's really anti-gravity. And this is interesting, but they were in the how do you say it? When you're only testing it, you're not in the final stage. You only want to test it, and then you can make it in series, you know? It doesn't mean that it is finished. I don't know how to say it. Do you know the word?
Prototype.
Prototype. They made a prototype of anti-gravity machines, but it doesn't mean that this is made in a large amount of UFO type of... But when the Second World War was a half a year longer, the Nazis would have won. They used this anti-gravity machine to win the war. But I'm happy that the Allies came fast enough to take it.
I think we all are.
Yes, but this is... If you know this, and we have the proof, then you're gonna think about differently about UFOs. Then you realize maybe a UFO is used to accept a world government because you present an alien threat or you present an alien race, which you can create yourself.
Yeah.
And then we say, okay, we don't trust no one, but maybe we trust something higher.
Yeah.
And that is
something to believe in.
Yes, and that's and also we have to realize that the Islam, the Muslims, and the Chinese. What will their reaction if UFO and aliens are presented as reality on the television? What will be their reaction?
Hysteria.
Yeah, but keep in mind, when they say, hey, this is interesting, we have to rethink everything what we've been taught, then they are maybe open to it to have a world government. And that's the reason why they do it in 1998 about. And yeah, this is a part of my also conspiracy marathon day. So realize people have to come 14 July. It will start on 1400 till 2200. So Lijnbaansgracht 92, telephone number of it's not necessary. You have to come 14 July Sunday, 1400 hours or 2 o'clock.
After. I'll be there.
Yeah. And there's one tip I want to give. I don't know if I have showed this one.
Yes. You did show that.
No, that was... No. This is the only planet of choice. It's important to read because this gave a lot of answers, a lot of questions. And for William Cooper, we have here William Cooper. This book, Behold the Pale Horse, you see here, Behold the Pale Horse. This guy, here you see him. This guy is from the Office of Naval Intelligence. And he talks about secret governments, he talks about UFOs and aliens and so forth, suppressed technologies. It's a very important book. I want to show Cooper tape. I have some Cooper tape.
That would be William Bill Cooper.
Bill Cooper. William Cooper. This is underground tape. Underground. This is one of my contacts. I've met him in Wembley Arena in London. I've talked with him, and I think he's genuine, but he warns for disinformation. He says there's a lot of information, UFO information going around the planet, and about 80% is baloney, and he says it is on purpose. They spread disinformation because...
To make people non-believers.
Not only non-believers, but... Even the believers will be attacked, and the believers will be doubt themselves because they have said, yeah, this is it, this we have to know. But he says, he starts with, don't believe a word I say, he says. That's his start his lecture. He says, check it out for yourself. I don't want people to say hallelujah. I want people go out of the couches and go up and research. And research doesn't mean that you have to be a professor. You can also read books. You can also go to library, go to lectures, go to spend some time and investigate videotapes. I have in my collection have 200 videotapes of documentaries, talk shows, news items, lectures on the subject of UFOs and the related subjects. Mm. So when you try to try to see what I saw, you have to watch for 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, three quarter year. You have to watch videos all over the world.
Considering a lot of them are bogus.
Not necessarily. It means sometimes when I see this rubbish, I don't want to have it anymore. So it's like I'm very selective. I had more, because more and more I realize I can filter, you know, UFOs as such is for a lot of people difficult to understand and what is a UFO. But when more and more people are watching it, seeing it, and seeing is believing, and experience it, there will be a time that enough is enough. Now it's time for the government to talk about it. What is their role to hide, why they are hiding it, and what is the reason? And I've mentioned the political, social it's upheaval we have when it's mentioned on CNN or whatever news. There was more what I want to say. We're going to also talk about cancer and AIDS possibly cured by ozone and oxygen therapies. So why doesn't no one knows about it? That you can cure yourself, but when you have more oxygen in your body, and most of your cells need oxygen, but because our body gets less and less oxygen, our immune system is lower and lower. But when you have more oxygen, your immune system goes up. So when you see you have bad...
So you just would breathe straight oxygen?
No, that's not the way it works. There are several ways to get more oxygen, like you have stabilized oxygen in water, it's H2O2. I don't know if you realize, Okay, you understand that. You drink it, then your oxygen will come in your blood. There's a way. But you can also, like this, you tap blood out of your filthy blood, which must be purified. Then it comes in ozone, O3, then it will be purified, and it will be the harmful disease will be attacked, the viruses, the bacteria, and so forth will be attacked by oxygen. Then it will be filtered, and then the clean blood comes back into you. And this is a way to clean your body, and this is a way to and I have also a tape of this guy, and he is the name is Ed McCabe.
Let's take a look at it.
A medical journalist, Ed McCabe, and he talks about also suppressed as well, because the pharmaceutical industry's therapy is cheap. And if you realize when you can cure yourself, a lot of diseases can be cured by oxygen and ozone therapies. It means that you don't can patent it. You don't have something to do barcode on it. You can be cured for a lot of diseases, so there is not much money involved. So when you take chemicals and so forth, they can patent it and they say you have to pay. But when you can cure yourself with oxygen and there's not much money. And there's also like rebirthing techniques, there's breathing techniques, that you have a lot of energy and oxygen in your body, and it also people have strange experiences with the right side of the brain, because I've heard that 60 till 80% of the oxygen we need goes to the brain. And if you don't have enough oxygen in your brain, you cannot think clear.
Yeah.
So when somebody asks stupid questions, sometimes I make a joke, you have not enough oxygen in your brain or something, because you need that, you need oxygen.
Can't live without oxygen.
No. And bacteria and so forth are being attacked by oxygen, but our cells will be mutating. If you have a cell, yes, a human cell, when there's only 20 or lower percent of oxygen, it goes mutate in a cancer. So when you have not enough oxygen, your body will be sick. Okay, we look part of journalist medical journalist Ed McCabe.
Today morning's paper, the weekend paper.
All right.
Controversial AIDS, quote, cure, unquote, to be explained. That sounds interesting. A man who claims to have found a cure for AIDS will speak on the Gold Coast tomorrow. Where's this guy? I didn't say this. Okay? I'm not saying this. I'm saying I know doctors that have told me that they have turned people negative, and we'll get into all that later on. Ed McCabe, an investigative journalist and author of the book Oxygen Therapy, says hundreds of HIV sufferers have lost the virus after undergoing voluntary treatment in oxygen therapies. I did say that. However, Gold Coast president of the Australian Medical Association, Dr. PH, said there was no documented case anywhere in the world of an HIV-positive person becoming HIV-negative. He challenged Mr. McCabe to produce evidence of his claims. And then he goes on to say, I'm creating false hope. He'd caution anybody from just going along in expectation of being cured. I don't know where people are going to go along to. I'm not taking anybody anywhere. Mr. McCabe said plenty of people who have AIDS no longer have any virus or secondary infections in their bodies because ozone has oxidized the harmful agents. He said oxygen therapies involve introducing a pure form of oxygen ozone into the body over a period of months, saturating every cell and detoxifying the body to eliminate disease. I did say that. Oxygen therapy is outlawed in the United States. I did not say that. Mr. McCabe will hold a full workshop, et cetera, et cetera. Well, this is typical. I'm not going to pick on your local official here, and there may be a representative in the office here or the doctor himself, and I'm glad you came. That means you have an open mind. You're willing to learn. But this is typical of the response from officials.
Yes.
They say, well, I've never heard of it, so it must not be true.
Exactly.
Now, I don't...
So, when you have never heard of it, it must be not be true.
Yeah.
I've talked with people who are investigating this type of work, and they come to the conclusion there are really people being cured in Switzerland, in Mexico, in Australia. But the trouble is, if you have proof that you're being cured and you go to a doctor...
So you never had it?
Or the doctor says, I don't want to talk about it. Mm. Because they lose their license to talk about it. Mm. There is so much at stake, and realize that if this is true and everybody knows about it, then you have the trouble that there is a viewpoint that there is an overpopulation of the world. And when cancer and AIDS is to be cured, what's about the population bomb?
Yes.
Yes. But that is a view of Club of Rome. They have 1975, there was the Global 2000 report. It says that 2000 or and the after, there should only be 2 billion people on this planet. It's 2 miljard in Dutch. A billion in America is different than billion here. A billion means more here.
It's different.
Yeah, it's strange, but it's so. So when I say billion, it means here miljard. So 2 billion people in 2010, so there are 4 billion too much, too many people. But these calculations are based on fossil fuel. We're using fossil fuel, and if you have a car who running on water or runs on... I have also proof that there is a car running on water, I have it with me. So it is interesting, when there is a car running on water, then the whole calculations are false. So the Earth can much more. So I've heard from people that the Earth can have 16 billion people if you have the right inventions.
Yes.
So now it comes boils down to suppressed inventions. So first I have to see the tape.
Let's take a look at the
suppressed invention.
Car running on water.
No, this is not, because everything is connected if you research this. It's like when you are like a flea on an elephant, you have a reality and on the elephant skin.
Yeah.
And you are a flea and I'm a flea and I talk to you for now. It's
hello.
Comfortable here. But there will be a time that I jump off the skin of the elephant and I see, hey, what is this? Hey, this is
there's a world around.
This is an elephant. You know what I mean? And this is also with this kind of material. You have all pieces of the jigsaw, huge jigsaw puzzle pieces I have. And I try to see the overview effect. And then I realize everything is connected. So you have suppressed inventions, you have UFOs, you have the secret societies, the intelligence community. What is our role in this whole play?
Yeah.
Our role is that we are obedient. But we have to stop to be obedient. We have to stop to be lazy and only watch football. And we have to do something about it, because the Earth is crying. The Earth is being raped. And we are part of the raping system.
Yes.
And I know that a lot of people are angry when I tell this, but I feel it's like this. We have to take responsibility for our own actions and not, okay, I'm pointing towards people, but first to do something about it, you have to realize that we are being lied to for a long time. And that's, he talked me about suppressed inventions, like, it's a German inventor, Günther Pöschel.
And I will understand.
Pöschel hat einen Motor gebaut, der angeblich mit Wasser läuft. Oliver Baus hat sich das mal angesehen.
Nehme einen Liter ganz normales Leitungswasser.
And a little bit oil, but he says he's developing more better machines.
Nehme einen Liter ganz normales Leitungswasser. Gieße es in den Tank, noch ein paar Tropfen Öl dazu, starte die Maschine und tatsächlich der Motor läuft. Kaum zu glauben, aber das Beste, auch hinten raus kommt nur Wasserdampf, Sauerstoff und verschiedene geringe Mengen von Kohlenstickoxiden. Praktisch abgasfrei
mit Wasser
betrieben, kein Hexenwerk, sondern jahrelange Entwicklungsarbeit. Diesel oder auch Öl wird durch Ultraschall mit Wasser gemischt und der so freigesetzte Wasserstoff verbrennt. Wenn die Entwicklung am
There's something important to say about a car running on water. It has to do with sounds. You can, if you have the right frequency, you can, a crystal glass will be exploding with the right frequency. You know that, eh?
Yes.
The energy you need to smash a glass is like, I don't know how much, but like 200 kilojoules, eh? I don't know how much, but you need energy to smash it. Mm-hmm. But if you have the right frequency, the same energy you need is to make this sound is much less, like maybe 50 kilojoules to make the sound, and the same action will be happening. So it's interesting to note that less energy creating the same effect, and this is also with water. You can water with a wave. I don't know how to say it in English, but when you have a wave, you can split in water, hydrogen, and in oxygen, and then it comes together again, and then you have a prototype of what you see here, and it is fully working, and you can use it, and it is. But the trouble is, what will be the oil company think about this?
It will be. It's a big money-making industry that will come collapsing.
So I think the Conspiracy Mountain Day deserves its label, the real X Files, and label Conspiracy Mountain Day, because I have a lot of information that's been suppressed. Mm. I will also talk about pyramids. who are bigger than in Egypt, in China. And I show them as well. I've not with me, but I will be showing